Thank you, everybody. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu Alaikum. I thank all of you present here. I get chance to introduce myself in this Cotton Outlook 2016 organized or produced by IBC Asia Informa Group, Informa Business Group. Right now, my presentation totally depends on no technical or something, it is reserve, production, consumption, and reserve. Beginning stock and consumption, then production. What is the? All this I will discuss. So far I know, I'll share all with you. Now see the fundamentals of cotton demand and supply. It's basically developed on this payment issues and quality issues. How we can ensure the payments and quality for the end user. To develop effective hedging strategy, it's a policy for ensuring the payment. Then critical economic issue for end user. If some other speaker told in this dais about the quality issues, our spinning mill owners or panel discuss about the 1,000 tons LC was opened and 500 tons is delivered, but quality is not okay. That was the big problem. In this sites, someone will be discussed or in the this audience will discuss this one. The raw cotton is the man-made fiber, not so artificial something. Man-made events raise to the economic stakes or issues. Even present price rates depend on course or premium. It depends on the price only. Cotton is the mainly staple length is very important. If you want to do the finer count, then premier length is very important. At that moment, price is for our country because we are the buyer for the cotton. The second largest buyer already emerged Bangladesh. So security locked in price, we cannot ensure the buyer. As a buyer, we want to secure our price. Then gradually, after 1982, the privatization of textile mill started when government adopted open market policy. That was the blooming era for us. There was the open the switch gate for the developing our country. We are seeking now to sustainable economy for the textile industry. So we want to do that. And we have the interest, and right now we have the position, and one market is asking us what you are doing, and now it is our position to change ourselves. How we can give the quality and time for the shipment of the goods. Now we are so many, our last discussion told us, now we are a vision 2021, where we are targeting the $50 billion will be exported from Bangladesh. But how is it possible? It is amazing. You can't think that. It is very simple. There is some calculation, geometrical, mathematical, whatever you like, you can do. But you have need the infrastructure changes over there. Otherwise, you can't do that. But there is the mitigated with the business body like BTMA, BGMA, PKMA, MPCCI, all other stakeholders, all together work for the make strategy. How we can achieve this? It is very tough, but we are talking it very easily. We are the target for within 5 years, we are going to double. Where GDP at present is 12% from the garment sector. Right now, we are thinking to double within 5 years, which we cannot achieve within 44 years, but how we can achieve this one only 5 years? Can you imagine? It is struggling time for us. From the BTMA and other stakeholders, those who are the industrialists and those who are the traders and suppliers also, all and everybody, if wings all together maybe work here, then it's possible. But it is not impossible. We have given the mission for this one. We are trying to meet the vision. You see right now, 2011 to there's some, the year is missing, don't take it otherwise. Capacity grown to 8.7 million spindle, and with the 385 bills, spinning mills in Bangladesh. There are some question arises that right now the staple fiber, man-made staple fiber over company with the natural fiber. So quality, for the quality over the demand of the customer or consumer, whatever you tell the retailer also they change their idea and fashion also or brand also. That's why right now cotton with the competing with the artificial fiber, but it is ignoring. Right now our country is possible to give you the support for as a backward linkage by the BTMA, BTM or Bangladesh Textile Mill Association leading the 413 factory at present with a capacity of 11.05 million spindle. They have the capacity to produce yearly consumption 2250 million kgs in a year. While our the fabrics producing operating scenario of Bangladesh, historical growth in use cotton of Bangladesh by this setup of, there is the 413 factories over there. You see the scenario of the thumb, I think it is the gradual up. And at the present situation, 2015, we are raising the two spindle number 11.05 million. Our production is 2,250 million cases in the year, which is what is a backward linkage. Backward linkage, linkage for the our garments industry. It is very good home. Well, now we are capable to support 90%, more than 90% in the need to add fabrics. Now see the scenario. It's a circle. From the beginning of 1971, at after 44 years, blooming in primary textile sector, second biggest cotton importer 2015 in Bangladesh. It is declared by a journal, Salmon JLU. It is reported. Our consumption rate of raw cotton 5.85 million bales yearly. Can you imagine it is how drastically from the comparison with the liberation time and up to this, we are changing our environment, our activity, skill and everything also. We have the talent, we are a skilled person already. Our human being, our Bangladesh human being is the skilled, and they have the capability to prove themselves in the world market. We believe, I believe also. And another good home, second largest exporter in the world of RMG, only behind the China. We are competing with the quality with the China. And the biggest one is the China in the cotton production and user also. They have the biggest cotton producing country, China. World biggest. Spindle number and everything over there. The exporting country, cotton exporting India, CIS, Africa, Australia, America, and Uzbek, Tajikistan. So many countries are interested to deliver their producing cotton to us. Right now, we have the platform to bargain with them, with the quality sides and other things. Reasons for higher demand of raw cotton in the Bangladesh at present perspective. There's the history of USA, the 95% import substitute is very hazardous or very harmful something. BCA president told that we have the opportunity to generate or produce the raw cotton in Bangladesh. But our infrastructure development already $4.5 billion in spinning sector. So can you imagine how much involvement with the bank, central bank or national bank with this sector? This is totally important, dependent on the import substitute like raw cotton. So about 160 million people over there. Everybody use this. Everybody use where, so it is needed to us. We have the market also. GSP issue from the European country, it is facilitated or accelerated the demand of our garments. Why cotton traders and suppliers in Bangladesh? What is the reason? So I said it because we have the investment 4.5 billion. So it's big investment. It is comparison with the liberation year up to this 44 years. we are making a platform for our ourselves. Spinning scenario, I told you last. Our fabrics, weaving factory, we have 790 or shuttle or shuttle lace. And any factory in Bangladesh, 30 that have consumed our coarser cotton staple length yarn. This is another slide. Tremendous growth of RMG sector. You see the slide. I think it will, it's very nice. There's a comparison with the knitwear, woven, and RMC. And company sum up with the RMC. ITD, where garments export the total GDP, 12% already achieved, we are capable to achieve. In 2013 to 2015, knitwear and woven garments, it is parallelly run. This is another scenario, it's comparison. Import scenario for the last few years. It is mainly focused on the India. It is a neighboring country. It is very easier to ship our goods within the road or ship, whatever we like. It minimize the lead time of the shipment. Because our all buyer of the garments, they have no lead time for more than 45 days or 60 days. So our raw materials and other things is very easier, and we can execute to the order if you find it. At this moment, India occupied our market 50%, almost 50%. You see the scenario from 2010 up to 2015. Gradually it is rising. India totally occupied. They are trying to, each and every month they are trying their symposium, seminar, everything, and promoted our buyer to purchase cotton from India. They have the quality. Sometimes they give us delivery with the deteriorated quality, ensuring they first, then our business will be more with them. Right now, it's very interesting. Like Bangladesh, South Asian country, Vietnam is rising. You see, Vietnam and Bangladesh. This is structure very, very, very close. Very, very close. Vietnam already expanding their investment in this sector, like Bangladesh. So Bangladesh is facing another troubleshooting in this sector. Vietnam is the competitor. Right now, Vietnam occupied the American market. Comparison with Bangladesh, they are very near. The supplier, the one, they are very much choiceable to import the goods from Vietnam than Bangladesh. And Pakistan, India, China is the biggest one. You see the curve is very, very sharply and high. Here, there is the 35,000 million. This is the top 10 country cotton producer. I told you, China is mainly the biggest producer. They have the yearly production of the 32.5 million bales. India is very near, 23.5 million bales. United States, but they are not the user. But they produce and sell to the other customer, like Pakistan, Brazil, Uzbekistan. So we have the opportunity to build up our career in the cotton sector, like other commodity, like rice and other things. Instead of this, we can produce the cotton. There is a market, 4.5 billion money involvement in this sector. So we have chance to sell our product within the domestic market. What about in stock and domestic consumption? It's the comparison, it's not so interesting, but there is the stock. Every year, world can produce 101 million bale per year. It is the forecasting, but there is a projection also. At a glance, foreign exchange earning in Bangladesh. Value in million USD. Knitwear sector, total RMG, BD total export, and projected also. You see the our vision, 2021 vision is projected, we will touch the 50 billion market. It is very interesting. We need to give the rapt attention in this sector. Otherwise, we cannot achieve this. everybody from political partition or other, those platform work with the industry. Everybody need to give the right attention for the development of power. At 50 billion target, it is very interesting and very must emerge in something. If you want to do that, we need at this all the points aggregated in a point. All the thumb come to the inner, like a hand, like five fingers in a hand, like this, we are all together one. There is no opinion diversity or multiplication. Everybody makes sense in a point. In a point, then it is possible. We can do the cotton supply chain management. It is, maybe you know, cycle for cotton use. Cotton use, cotton, basically it is like a literature. So cotton mainly it's white. White is the piece of, white is the index of piece. So that's why it cannot make hazard. Cotton is very interesting and useful or user friendly for the human beings. SWOT analysis over there. The strength, opportunities, and other things. My slide is not clear. So I think over there, some information is there. The strength over there to have good relation with the buyer and seller to mitigate the issues. Whatever arises over there, the positive response from government to the mitigate issues is strong. A strong field for cotton uses. This is a good interesting point for the supplier those give the supply in Bangladesh. USDA markup, Bangladesh is the second biggest importer in the world. Assurance of the payment against the supplier got under UPDC 600. There's the opportunities over there. There's so many things is there. That's all I think. There's some recommendations. I can't see this recommendation. Excuse me, I have the slides and I can read this on. It will help you. Sorry. If you allow me, I go back for SWOT analysis. I'll go back for SWOT analysis thing. Yeah. Right now I can see. Opportunities is to ensure manufacturer garments with the quality. Men's and women's wear to treat as a market leader is the big opportunity. To treat as a Bangladeshi nation in the world market. Chance to focus Bangladesh in the global world in fashion arena. It's another chance. Skill nurturing is called to prove to shine national dignity to circulate huge money in this subsector, PTS, primary textile sector. The weakness offers there to change monetary stock up, not available arbitration to solve any dispute arises in contract or LCs also. No ready controller to check financial losses, still not any recovery body to protect fund. This is the beneficiary of the spinner or miller to find one-stop service we are seeking, one-stop service to deliver the raw cotton. I have made some recommendation for ensuring the good business or good market in the demand supply issues. To increase the EDF for facilitating adequate import as per requirement of the millers. To adjust period may extend up to 1 year instead of 180 days. To ensure cotton quality before shipment, inspection must be done by pre-qualified internal inspection firm. If you want to flourish ourselves in the international arena, there is a good chance like niche sector, open sector will be competed. I think so within 2021 vision, we can be successfully do that. Like niche sector with the open sector parallel work with us. That's all. Thank you very much for patient hearing.